guys, welcome back to another American Truck Simulator video. My name is Moose78. Hopefully you're all doing well today, by the way. And we're back at it again with another Stories on the Road video. Another trip I made on one of my live streams there. And today we're running the Kenworth T680, pulling around the East Genesis end dump, and we're going to be running from Barstow over to Santa Maria. So it's a pretty good trip, nice scenic trip. I think you guys will enjoy it. So I'm just going to go ahead and cut on over to the gameplay footage, but real quick, if you want to catch my Twitch streams, link for that is down in the video description, so be sure to check that out. Come over, say hi, hang out for a little bit, it's always a good time. But we'll cut on over to the gameplay for now, and we will catch you guys later. But one of my buddies shot me a message there on Facebook the other day, said, "Hey, want a copy of the trailer to do a video on?" Well, let me think about it. Yeah, okay. So, between Santa Maria and Santa Cruz, not on the open beta, I haven't. Like, I just went from, where the heck did I go? I think I went from, like, San Francisco to El Centro, and then just from, Yuma up to, back up to El Centro, or, Barstow. I can't remember if I went that way the other day on the stream or not. No, we ran down the coast. Dadgummit. Check something real quick. Do-do-do-do. No dead zone in it, so I have to just adjust it in the Logitech settings. But yeah, that trailer is pretty sweet. There is going to be a public release of it. I don't know when yet. I'd imagine with the update we just got, they're going to go back and do even a little bit more to it than they already had planned. Since, you know, we have liftable trailer axles now. The only thing I've really noticed with it, it's a little bit squirrely to get hooked up to. And as I say that, I get it on the first try. Maybe I should do that more often. Yeah, there's no way I can get this trailer backed up to the dock. That's usually the case, though. So, there it is. I'll hop out in the free camera here. The East Genesis end dump. Looks pretty sharp, I gotta say that. Gotta say that. Like I said, I'm gonna do a finish up my review on this trailer. Sorry, I had to get something to drink there. Finish up my review on this trailer later today, and probably later on this evening, should go live on my YouTube channel. Right. Let's see how long we have before. Let's see. Remains. Somebody only got 3 hours to deliver it. Next rest stop in 7 hours and 22 minutes. Let's hop in here. Let's see. Trip time, 6 hours and 49 minutes. So we should be able to get up there, or get over there, I should say. The wheels. Those wheels. Then the wheels I'm using on the trailer are just off of the utility trailers from the workshop. But yeah, this was originally converted over from Bora's Mack end dump from way back in the Holland days. You know, like I said on the last stream there, it's really cool to see a lot of these old Holland mods finally making their way to ATS, and they're finally getting some pretty good conversions, nice and clean. The customization, could you be more specific? How to customize them, or let's see, what are we weighing there? That is 36,000 pounds, so not too extremely heavy. Definitely seems like the fuel consumption is a little bit more realistic now. And we just fueled up what back there in Yuma, and we've already used a good quarter of a tank. Wheels in the About tab, you can so you just want to see like the hub and like the nuts and all that stuff. Probably not right away, but maybe here in a little bit, we'll see. Clip a car yet today coming off a ramp. Five right down to a 40, down to a 35, and then in about a second, we're right back to a 55. Thanks for the follow there, James. Do appreciate it. Just send me a message on Discord or whatever. How you doing, James? Welcome to the stream. Thanks for stopping by and hanging out today. Car, you can stop rubbernecking. I did notice they got a Camaro in the AI now. That's pretty cool. Like I said, I've been busy, man. I'm usually not on Discord all that much, honestly. Between work, family, and, you know, everything else, I, you know, don't have that much time usually to, you know, hop on Discord. You know, like I said before, I just kind of do this as a hobby and, you know, when I have time. And luckily, my schedule's been working out here lately to where I've had a couple hours during the day due to a couple streams and stuff like that. Before I get ticket number two, better resume El Cruzo. And a stinking Camaro, man. Come on. It's a Camaro. Drive that thing like it's stolen. There you go. If you guys remember, back before the rescale, this used to be a two-lane. Pause here for a second, get something to drink. Sorry about that. Oh, nice, man. Yeah. I wouldn't say a huge car guy, but, you know. Do like some cars. Like a lot of the old muscle cars, but I like some of the new cars they've came out with. You know, like, I like the new Camaros. I think those are pretty sweet. Really like the new Challengers. I think those are pretty awesome. I like those a lot more than the Chargers. I think some of the Chargers look cool as police vehicles, as cop cars. But, man, the new Challengers have that kind of old-school muscle car look. Love the Mustangs, too, man. Love the Mustangs. I'd love to have, like, a 2008 Shelby GT500. That would be pretty freaking sweet. Like, I know someone in my area that has a Super Snake. I think it's like 750 horsepower. Things like ridiculous. My buddy's got a Challenger that it's kind of turned into a show car. He takes around and a lot of the local car shows and stuff. More than anything, I'm a truck guy. You know, I grew up in the trucking industry. You know, my dad drove truck for, you know, a little over 40 years over the road. So, you know, that's what I grew up around. So, you know, like some guys are car guys, you know, I'm a truck guy. You know, I like a lot of the classic old trucks, a lot of the old school trucks, you know, your old school Peterbilt 359s, your old school, you know, Kenworth K100s, old school W900 A models, which I used in the stream the other day, which I'll get some content of that up on the channel next week as well, on the YouTube channel. For some of the people that aren't able to make it over to the streams. I know I stream kind of a weird time a day for, you know, the U.S. and everything. I stream, you know, early morning. Well, kind of early morning, I guess. I usually start around 10 a.m., then usually go to about noon, 1 o'clock. Whereas a lot of streamers, you know, don't stream, you know, until nighttime, but... But, you know, I was fortunate enough to kind of grow up in a pretty cool era for trucking. I mean, you know, the early 80s, you know, the mid to late 80s, a lot of cool trucks. You know, I got to ride around in a 359 back in the day. My dad got to drive one of those for a while. Cab over P 352. Flat top K100. You know, unfortunately, you know, he never got to own his own truck or anything like that. You know, we got close to it once. Got real daggone close to it once. I mean, the point where we were talking to the dealership about financing, I think it was like 99, 2000, somewhere in there. We were looking at buying a Freightliner Classic and going into business for ourselves. You know, he was going to officially teach me up on how to drive and all that stuff. And, you know, we were going to run team for a few years. You know, we pretty much already had a trailer picked out. We were going to have a Great Dane spread axle reefer. Then we were going to drive. He was going to drive for a few years, then retire. And then, you know, kind of, you know, he was going to go behind the scenes and, you know, kind of run the company, you know, the day-to-day operations. And I was going to be out, you know, on the road doing the driving and all that stuff. But unfortunately, never came to fruition. But definitely glad I got to... you know, experience a lot of the stuff that I did growing up in the trucking industry. Got to see a lot of cool things in my day. You know, kind of the weird thing about, you know, being a truck driver and all that stuff is you get to see a lot of cool stuff, but yet you don't get to go really, you know, like you would like on a vacation or a tourist trip or something like that. But, you know, I didn't get to see, you know, face to face, you know, the Twin Towers, but I got to see the Twin Towers in the New York City skyline before, you know, those tragic events. You know, I've been through the Everglades numerous times, like long before it kind of got all populated and, you know, the interstate kind of runs through there now. And but back in the day, man, it was just, you were out in the middle of a swamp and, you know, a sunny day, you'd see alligators all over the place. So got to see some pretty cool stuff, that is for sure. So that's kind of how, you know, that's kind of my ties to trucking and stuff like that. And that's, you know, why I'm so much or so into, you know, truck sims. You know, it's kind of my connection to the, you know, trucking industry and all that stuff. Definitely interested to see what SES has in store for us next. Like I was saying earlier on the stream, you know, this is kind of a small update, but some nice little features kind of here and there that I think we're really going to get to experience here in the coming weeks as a lot of the modders out there start to work on some new trailers and stuff. Yeah. And I really thought we were going to do it. I mean, you know, we had some pretty lengthy conversations about it, had everything all planned out, how everything was going to work and all this stuff. And but, it, you know, it's looking back on it, it's, you know, probably best that we didn't, because it was, you know, it was shortly after that that, you know, the U.S. economy kind of took a hit, and it was a little bit rough on owner-operators out there for a while, so. But it still would have been daggone cool. You know, because I went with my dad a lot. I mean, from like the time I was 9 till probably about 21. And of course, the older I got, it became less of, you know, a summer trip to, you know, I was working with my dad in the summers. You know, so I was, you know, pretty much doing everything that he was. Really didn't get to drive a whole lot just because, you know, didn't want to jeopardize losing a job or anything like that if, you know, for whatever reason I would have got pulled over or something like that. But, you know, everything else, you know, I was out there working. And it's pretty cool. I mean, as you, you know, get, you know, talk to some people within, you know, the truck sim community, a lot of people have similar stories, so it's pretty cool. And a lot of people kind of, you know, are growing up or have grown up, you know, in the trucking industry. And just seeing a lot of the guys, you know, as they've got older, have went into trucking. To get some truck shows kind of here and there. Unfortunately, where I'm at, there's like nothing ever really close. It's always, you know, no matter what direction it is, it's like a 3 or 4 hour drive one way, so it's like, ah. So, you know, pretty much comes like a weekend trip or a little bit of an undertaking, but I know the Mid-American Truck Show, or the MATS, as it's called, that's coming up here at the end of this month, and man, I'd love to get down to that just once. It takes place down in Louisville, Kentucky, and it's like the biggest truck show in the world, but it's a little bit more than just a truck show. It's, you know, a lot of the vendors, you know, kind of debut, you know, their new stuff for 2017. Some of the truck manufacturers are debuting new truck models, you know, for the upcoming model year. There's always just some amazing trucks down there. And I know the last few years I've caught some of them, you know, coming back up north. Got to see some pretty cool ones. A couple famous ones kind of here and there too, so. Like how some guys are with car shows, that's how I am with truck shows. I love it. Like the last one I went to was the ATHS, the American Truck Historical Society National Show. A few years back it came to my area, so got to check that out. A lot of cool old school trucks. You know, a lot of trucks from like the 70s and 80s, even like back to the 50s, 40s and stuff like that. Got to see an old Kenworth 521, which was awesome. That Jake Brake Doe. If I had an opportunity to become an owner-operator, that's a good question. That is really a good question. Because I'd be on the fence, You know, what I want... What I want, something like, you know, some of the new Aero trucks, or what I, you know, want to go kind of old school and go with like a, you know, 389, or a, you know, older 379, or like a W900. You know, I hear a lot of guys talk about, you know, these Aero trucks aren't really, as far as, you know, kind of the fuel savings and stuff, and all that stuff, they're not really much better, if any better. In some cases, some of them are worse than a lot of, you know, the Peets and Kenworths and stuff like that. But if anything, I would probably kind of go middle ground. I'd probably go with like a 579 owner-operator spec. There is a dealership out in Oklahoma that they have a YouTube channel. It's Peterbilt Steve. I think it's Steve Carbone, Steve Carboni. Probably something, if you guys, you know, search his channel. Oops. Probably go with something like that. And then as cool as having a spread axle, you know, reefer would be, I'd probably go with something like a 53-foot reefer, you know, just because you can get more freight on there, and, you know, more freight's more money. That's probably something what I'd go with. Because these newer Aero trucks, they do have a lot of creature comforts for drivers, a lot of room. So you can get them kind of move around pretty easy. You don't have to worry about, you know, squeezing through a couple seats to get back to the sleeper, and plenty of room in the sleeper. You know, really comfortable trucks. Remember one time my dad's buddy had his own W900 and wanted my dad to take a trip for him over the weekend one time. Got to tag along with them, and holy cow, I couldn't believe, you know, there wasn't really a whole lot of room between him and I. Like, man, this is kind of cozy. But, you know, a lot of the newer trucks, you know, you got a little bit more room, kind of stretch out, and just a little bit more comfortable. One of my friends that I know that drives truck, he was just looking at a 579. Brand new 579. But if I wasn't going practical and, you know, just kind of going all out, it'd be like a 389 or an older, you know, late model, you know, 379 with a spread axle reefer. That would be pretty stinking awesome. Coming in hot. So typically this isn't too bad to park here. The trailer's not extremely long. You gotta have that cool factor. That's one thing I really like about, you know, that guy out there in Oklahoma, that Steve Carbone. The trucks he sells look good. I mean, yeah, they're an Aero truck, but they don't have any of the side skirts on them. They got all polished aluminum steps, polished aluminum tanks. They have the LED, you know, cab lights along the side. you know, not a crazy long wheelbase, but a little bit of a longer wheelbase. I think they're typically 285-inch. I think some of them might even have, you know, come stock or come with, like, a two-piece light bar and stuff like that. So, I mean, they're good-looking trucks. And the same thing with the 680. I mean, if you spec a 680 out like this in real life, I'd drive it all day long. And these things are huge on the inside. Guys, that's going to wrap it up for another American Truck Simulator video. Hope that you guys enjoyed it. If so, just give it a like and a share. This helps me out a bunch and helps the channel grow. And if you're new to the channel and are not already subscribed, please take a look around, watch a couple videos, and consider subscribing now. And if you want to catch me over there on Twitch, link for my Twitch channel is down in the video description. Feel free to come over, say hi, hang out. But to the next video, stay safe out there, guys. Take care, and we'll be seeing you.